Hi everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use GPT-4o, the new model from OpenAI, in semantic kernel applications. So on May 13th, 2024, OpenAI announced GPT-4o, their new model that can reason across audio, vision, text in real time. So standing for Omni, is a step towards more human-computer interaction. So essentially, we can get any input from text, audio, and image and video, and we can generate video, audio, image as outputs. It can respond to audio inputs in shorter time, so around 232 milliseconds with an average of 320, which is very similar to human response time in a conversation. It matches GPT-4 Turbo performance in English and in code with improvements in text for non-English languages. And it's also faster and 50% cheaper in the API. And GPT-4o is especially better at vision and audio compared to other existing models. Now, in the Azure OpenAI world, there's a preview at the moment that Microsoft have launched through OpenAI. So you can actually use GPT-4o models in Azure OpenAI today. However, it's just in preview. So if I go into Azure OpenAI, here in my Azure OpenAI studio, I can see that I've got early access playground to GPT-4o model. So what I'm going to do with this, I can actually provide this playground with an image and also get it to describe an image as well. So what I've done, I'll just access my downloads. And earlier on, I downloaded an image of the National Gallery here in Victoria, right here in Melbourne. And I'll just get GPT-4o to describe this image. There we go, let it do its thing. Thinking about it, taking some time. And here we go, here's a response. So the image shows the exterior of the National Gallery of Victoria in Melbourne, Australia, characterized by its distinct gray stone, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Fantastic. And it's also picked up, there's a water feature and there are a couple of people sitting by it. Fantastic. So from an open Azure OpenAI perspective, it's in preview. Microsoft Build at the time of recording is coming around the corner. So maybe we'll see it released and available as deployments in the near future. However, if we wanted to try this out today and work with it in our applications, we can actually do this using the semantic kernel. So what I'm going to do, I've already created a new project and just get rid of that. And let me just get some code going. So I've got I'll just copy and paste some things that are just a little bit boilerplate. So I've got my app settings in a JSON file. So I'm loading stuff like my API key, my API key, my organization key, etc. But I'm just going to add model as a variable to just show you that I'm using the new GPT-4o model. So here I'm going to start building up my kernel. So I'm going to yo builder dot. Add OpenAI chat completion, not Azure OpenAI. Copilot is having all kinds of fun with me today. Cool, so I'm gonna pass in the model, which will be GPT-4o. Then I will provide my config for my OpenAI key. And then also my OpenAI organization key. Now I have done a video where I've showed you how you can actually set this all up using the OpenAI rather than using Azure OpenAI if you don't have access to Azure OpenAI. So please check that video. I've put a link to it in the description. So please check it out if you haven't got that set up already. So now I'm in a position to build my kernel. I'll let autocomplete do its thing. Cool. And now I can start building out my semantic kernel to actually use this GPT-4o model. So what I'm going to do is for all my chat services, I'm actually going to get a required service and I'm going to use the iChat completion service. And then I'm going to create a new chat history. my touch type can actually help me out today. Fantastic. Cool. So then I'll add a system message. So I'll basically tell my agent that they're going to be a helpful. So you are a friendly and helpful assistant. That responds to questions directly. Cool. So now I can create my user message, and I'm going to need to add two things. So this is going to be stored in an object called chat message content item collection. And there are a couple of things that I want to add here. First is the text content, and this is going to be the prompt. So earlier when I said, can you please tell me what is in this image? This is essentially what that is. So this is the text prompt that I'm going to provide to Semantic Kernel. And then I'm going to get the image content, the actual content. Don't forget the comma content here. And I'm going to just point to the URI of that. Let me just do a quick copy and paste. Fantastic. There we go. Cool. There we go. Nice short URI for all of us. Nice. Okay. So then I'm going to add that to my chat history. So I've got my system message and I've got my user message. So now what I'm going to do is just get a result back from GPT-4o. So get chat message content sync and pass through the history, pass through that chat history. And then what I'm going to do, let me describe that for you. And then just print out the result as part of that. Fantastic. Cool. So just to recap before we build this and run this, I'm loading up my configuration settings from my app settings.json file. My model, I'm setting it to GPT-4o. I'm building out my kernel. So I'm adding the OpenAI chat completion module and getting the required service for iChat completion service. And then I'm creating my new chat history. So I've got a system message saying, or basically directing my agent to say that you're a friendly and helpful assistant that responds to questions directly. And then I'm passing through my prompt. So for my text content, I'm saying, can you tell me what's in this image? And then I'm passing through the URI of the image that I showed you earlier. Cool, so let's give that a run. Cool, and through the power of video editing, I've just sped that up a little bit, but after a short while, we get our description from our text. So this image shows the exterior of an art gallery or museum, likely in the National Gallery. The building is made of stone or brick with a large entrance to the archway. So it's pretty similar to what we saw in the Azure Playground, which is pretty, pretty cool. Cool. With this new model, GPT-4o, we could actually try this out with audio if we wanted. So say if we had audio files, we could instruct the model to say, can you tell me what the content is of this audio clip? And we can do that as well. We could try out new images, and we could also do code generation and text like previous models from OpenAI. Cool. If you need any more directions on how the GPT-4o model works, I really recommend checking out the API docs. So here we can see how you can actually consume the model. It's literally just as simple as calling this model. It's going to point to the latest version of that model along with how much training data is available for GPT-4o Omni. And there's also text generation guides on how to actually use it. You can try it in their playground as well if you don't have access to Azure OpenAI. Cool, so that wraps up this video. All of this code is going to be uploaded to my GitHub, so please check out the link to my GitHub for this code in the description below. If you like this video, give it a like. I'm going to do more content on Semantic Kernel in the future, also Azure OpenAI. I also do a bunch of content on Azure and programming languages such as Rust, C Sharp, and a little bit of Go. So if you want to see that content, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.